الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. Brothers and sisters, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for being among those who are sitting here. We always say we must remember those who are on their bed, on the sick bed. They cannot move, they cannot go to the mosque, they can't do anything if nobody helps them. We have to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for making to these places here or anywhere else, because this is a gift from Allah, no money can buy it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, when he addressed Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says to Rasul, Al-yawma akmaltu lakum dinakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa raditu lakum al-islam ad-dina. This day I have perfected your deen for you, completed my favor upon you, and chosen for you Islam as your only religion. Why? There will not be any matter that the Quran did not talk about it, that the Quran did not solve it. That's why Allah says, I perfected your deen for you. So whatever happened, refer to the Quran, you will find a solution. Yes, the favor of Allah upon us are many and cannot be counted. The greatest among them is that he has guided us to Islam. If he subhanahu wa ta'ala had not guided us to Islam, we would not have been guided. This is a guidance. We are here, we say la ilaha illallah. Let's be grateful to Allah for this. We meet here today on this Juma to pray and listen to this khutbah, as a result gathering in one place, worshiping one Allah, even though we have differences in our opinion about our matters. But when we call ourselves Muslim and go on to call ourselves Mu'min, all these differences must stay away, and we must apply and work with the book that was revealed to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam 1,000 years ago, where Allah says about the book, the Quran, وَإِنَّهُ لَكِتَابٌ عَزِيزٌ لَا يَعْتِيهِ الْبَاطِلُ مِنْ بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ وَلَا مِنْ خَلْفِهِ تَنْزِيلٌ مِنْ حَكِيمٍ حَمِيدٌ. And verily, this is a honorable, well-fortified, respected book. Quran is a respected book. No matter what you do, when you see it, you love it. Even though if you are not a Muslim, when you see the book of Allah, you will respect it, you will love it. But your mind will say, no, I don't like it. But inside you, you know what the importance of this book. Because it's Allah's speech, and he has protected it from corruption. In this book, nobody can corrupt. All that book we write, all the constitution, whatever we want, somebody come, we change it according to our standard of living. But this Quran, it cannot be altered. The way it was revealed to Rasul, this is the way it's still there. It is only protected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Falsehood cannot come to it from before it or behind it. Sent down by Allah, all wise, worthy of all praises. Allah says, Inna hazihi ummatukum ummatan wahidatan wa ana rabbukum fa'budun. Allah is talking about our nation, the nation of Islam. The nation of Islam, the brotherhood between us. He says, this is truly your ummah. It's not different ummah, it's not separated ummah. It's one ummah. And I am your Lord, therefore submit to me alone. Don't worship anybody else. This is how Allah wants us to be a united ummah, a united community, a united, wherever you go, you are Muslim, but it doesn't matter whether you're coming from any country, we all stay Muslim. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying about it, a united ummah. A united ummah. Rasul has been talking about it. Stay one ummah, Do not separate, do not bring differences among yourself. Always be the ummah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is why Allah ordained in this religion everything that strengthens the bond of love and harmony. He subhanahu wa ta'ala even warned us against anything that separates the believer's heart. Don't come with something that will separate my heart from the other. Always try to unite people. Always try to bring people together. That's why he said, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخْوَيْكُمْ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. The believers are nothing else than brothers and sisters. With nothing else, brothers and sisters. Allah made us Asian, African, European, American, so we know each other. Apart from that, when we come to the masjid, when we call ourselves Muslim, we are brothers and sisters. There is no nationality that we will ask you at the door, can you show me your passport? Can you show me your identity? No. In Islam, wherever you go, there is no nationality. We are all one ummah, one family. He says to Rasul, وَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِهِمْ لَوْ أَنْفَقْتَ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا مَا أَلَّفْتَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِهِمْ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ أَلَّفَ بَيْنَهُمْ إِنَّهُ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. Oh Rasul, do you think it's because of the love between me, Allah, and you that I united your people? No. This is an act from me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And he has united the heart of all the Sahaba. They were one ummah. One brothers, the whole Muslim come in support for him. That's why Allah said, I united their heart. If you had spent all that is in the earth, you could not have united their heart, but Allah has united them. Certainly he is almighty, all wise. If Allah wants us to be united, and one single or two people or some people want us to be separated, let tell them the truth. You are not welcome in this kind of community. Please stay away, because we want to be a united ummah. In this khutbah, brothers and sisters, let us remember the saying of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describing the believer, what was reported by Imam Abu Bukhari and Muslim. مَثَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فِي تَوَادِّهِمْ وَتَرَاهُمِهِمْ وَتَعَاتُفِهِمْ مَثَلُ الْجَسَدِ إِذَا اشْتَكَى مِنْهُ عَدْوٌ تَدَعَى لَهُ سَائِرُ الْجَسَدِ بِالسَّهَرِ وَالْهُمَى. Which said, the believers having love among themselves, being merciful among themselves, and being kind to each other are like one single body. If any part of the body is not well, the whole body shared the sleeplessness and the high fever with it. It's one thing touch one brothers, we must all feel that same, and then we have to be united, we have to be together, we have to be one single body to kick out that illness among ourselves. Brothers and sisters, to deepen this brotherhood among us, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam orders us to be merciful, help in clearing the hardship and distress, and help in satisfying the need. He said what was reported by Imam Bukhari and Muslim in two hadiths, man la yarham la yurham. Those who do not have the heart with Muslim, Allah will not have his mercy upon them. He who's not been merciful with people, Allah will not be merciful with him. And the second hadith said, the Muslim is a brother to another Muslim. He does not oppress him. No matter what, you don't oppress your brothers to anybody. You don't go to anybody outside the Muslim community to oppress your brothers, to report your brothers. Brothers, what do you want? Do you want others to come and solve our problem? No. We have Quran, we have hadith. Our problem can be solved with the Quran. Whoever leave the Quran and go and seek help from another people, the kuffar, people who do not believe in us, people who want to destroy us. Brothers, you are munafiq. You are a destroyer. We must combat you with the Quran and the sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we will do it, inshallah. Brothers and sisters, let's stay within this community. Let's stay with them the Quran and the Sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasul says, and whoever clear a distress for a Muslim. Look how stressful we've been through these 2 weeks. We all scared. What is going to happen to our masjid? We are all scared. We worried. Oh, brother, how can you put that distress on people's hearts? You come into the masjid, you don't know who's there. Presently, we have police among us listening to what we are saying because some people want trouble. Brothers, let's stay away from all these people. Let's be better than them. Let's follow the Quran. The Quran said, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a peace. We have to be peaceful. We must stay peaceful until the end of the our matters. If you clear a distress for a Muslim, look what Allah will do for you. Allah will clear for the person the distress of the day of judgment. That day is very difficult. To protect this great brotherhood against any incident which might happen among the believers, since they are human beings, those people who are doing this thing, we are all human beings. Maybe Shaitan was powerful over them. Maybe Shaitan was over them. We seek Allah protection from Satan. Let's not blame them. Let's pray for them. Inshallah, Allah will bring them back to our community. Let's pray for them. Maybe the Shaitan is so powerful. It's the Shaitan who come among us and cause disturbance. Please, let's kick out Shaitan from us and let's pray for these people. This is what Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to do. Rasul never met fire with fire. Whenever somebody come and they want to attack Rasul, Rasul pray for them. Oh Allah, guide them. Maybe what they are doing, they don't know. Maybe Shaitan is over them. Please, Shaitan, a'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim. Innamal muzminuna ikhwatun fa aslihu baina akhwaikum wa taqullaha la'allakum turhamun. The believers are nothing else than brothers. We are brothers. So make reconciliation. Let's make reconciliation between ourselves, because nobody can do this if we don't come forward and apologize to each other. Dear Muslim brothers and sisters, after we hear all of this, we know what is the right way that we have to follow to achieve the brotherhood among us and to protect it against what my threaten is. We in this blessed gathering in this Friday have to start through steps toward love and harmony. Let's forget what might have happened among us from fault or anything that was not done on purpose. Let's forget about it. This is gone. We look forward. Let's decide on achieving more tie of relationship among us. Let's remember everything that Allah asks us to do. Look at what Allah says. We end up our khutbah with وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Look how beautiful is the Quran. You will never find this in any text apart from the Quran. When Allah says to Rasul, tell them, let pardon and forgive. I pardon, I Allah. I forgive, I Allah. Let them pardon and let them forgive. Do you not love Allah? Do you not love that Allah should forgive you? Whenever we do something, we rush to the mosque, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, oh Allah, forgive me. If your brother does something to you, he stresses you in whatever he does, please forgive him. Please pardon him. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have his mercy upon all of us. Dear Muslim brothers and sisters, there are many things that will increase our brotherhood. Let's bring all these things that will protect our relationship and that will increase it. May Allah give us good understanding. May Allah give us the tawfiq. May Allah protect us from all evil within ourselves. May Allah give them al-jannah. May Allah protect us from anything that will destroy the Muslim ummah. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina azabanna. Rabbana la tuzigh qulubana ba'da idh hadaytana wa hab lana min ladunka rahmatan innaka antal wahhab. Ibadallah. Rahimakumullah. إن الله يعمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.